the text message that I sent to my friends last night.
Last night, Brenda Lira did something she thought she would never do. She came out to her friends and told them she was undocumented.
I've been living in fear, not only for myself, but for my family, for people that I know. Fear that my parents will be ripped away from me, that I'll be ripped away from them, ripped away from the land that I've called home for the past 19 years.
The 21-year-old says simply she was tired of being scared.
I think it's time for us to be united, to present a strong front, to actually fight for what we want.
And she's not alone. Lira is part of a growing chorus of undocumented immigrants in the U.S. who are coming out of the shadows. People like Valeria Zamora, who lives with her family in New Orleans. 5 years ago, she immigrated to the U.S. illegally from Honduras to work in manual labor. She doesn't like it when people tell her she should go back.
This is my country. This is my country. I came here and I helped rebuild it.
Valeria and her husband are in the U.S. illegally and took a big risk of being on camera with us. But like Brenda, they say it sends a message to President Donald Trump, we are not afraid. Ironically, they thank President Trump for giving them a reason to stand up.
I honestly think he's kind of supporting us in a way.
They're joined by people like Jonathan Ramirez, a 22-year-old who's in the U.S. illegally. We met recently outside of Atlanta. He too is empowered, he says, to fight.
He's coming against us, but the people, the community, they're coming more united in a way, you know, to come towards a plan or towards an action of what's going to happen.
So this is you as a little girl?
Yeah, that's me.
Back in Tennessee, Brenda Lira knows she's a little more safe than her counterparts in Atlanta or New Orleans. She's a dreamer and has deferred action, or DACA, but she's still nervous about her future. She worries about those who will find out from this interview that she is undocumented. She hopes one day that they see her as American.
I think I am the definition of being American. I'm an immigrant. I work for everything that I want. I pay my taxes. A lot of us pay our taxes. We find our way to not do anything illegal. We try to follow all the laws except, of course, coming to this country illegally.
Unfortunately, to her critics, that's the one thing they may never get past. Oh.